You know, Tom, I represent machine manufacturers, and I've noticed over the years these machine manufacturers are going to far greater steep taper drafting. Be able to have the same size motor all the way down the machine, get higher speeds at the finish end, and try to keep normal cooling steady throughout the whole drafting program. The thing that upsets me though is we sell machines with very steep tapers. We don't talk to our customers about the importance of having the proper die angle to match up to these very light area of reductions towards the finish size side of wire drawing. Don't you think our customers need to know the importance of a die angle compared to draft requirements?
Absolutely, Don. It's a great point. I see this often when I visit a customer after they've put in their new high-speed wire drawing machine and they can't get the finish dies to stay in the machine for a long enough time period.
Sure.
So what happens is when you taper draft and you're going from an extreme of say 30-35% all the way down to say an 11-18% reduction
in the dead block,
you can't have the same die angle because it's going to contact in that approach angle at different locations. And a proper location where we want to see that wire hit is about a third of the length of the approach angle to no more than half the length of the approach angle. And as that changes with light reductions, it starts to fall below that third. And as it falls below that third, it is only using a very small part of that angle. As it starts to go above half, it is consuming almost the entire length of that angle. So you almost have to sometimes go with three different die angles within a wire drawing machine, which is a logistics nightmare.
Right.
For the die shop.
Most die shops have 12 degree dies, and that's right. All they have. Or they have 16 degree dies, and that's all they have. I need to try to go in and tell my customers, you've bought a great draw machine, but now you're gonna have to carry 6 degree, 12 degree, and 16 degrees. They look at me like I'm crazy. But they have to, I think, understand how critical it is to have the proper approach angle.
That's right. And because of the logistics nightmare, not only in the die shop of keeping all those different inventories, but then making sure that your drawing operator picks the right angle and putting it in the right spot, because if you have three or four machines with different processes, now we get the wrong die angle in the wrong location. So what we try to do is we use a chart that gives us a range that ties the area reduction to the contact point within the die, and saying if you work within this band, you are going to have good drawing success and good die life as long as the rest of the process is right. So what we can do is take those 6 degree die angles and see what range of area reduction we can use and hopefully limit ourselves to maybe 2 die angles instead of having to go as many as 3, making the logistics problem a little easier, but also getting a higher rate of success on die life and product quality.
Well, I've seen your chart, and I know what you're talking about. There's an overlap.
There's an overlap, yes.
And as long as you stay within that overlap, you're maybe not gonna be hitting exactly at this halfway point, but
correct,
you'll be in a zone where the die will work without blowing out on you or getting no lubrication and scratching.
That's
so
correct.
You're right, at least the plant could have 2 die angles rather than just the one.
That's correct. And the other thing about not only blowing out is we should be getting better product quality, not only in diameter and less scratching, but also metallurgically.
Because the high carbon people have to worry about that delta factor.
Exactly.
Hit that approach angle in the right position.
And the delta factors between this third and half are going to be in very acceptable for most high carbon, even at higher speeds. So that's why we tried to simplify it to reduce the number of die angles and to be able to give you a range. So I try to get the planning department to say, listen, these are our 2 die angles. When you're setting up the drafts on the machine for a new customer, make sure you're keeping them within those reductions, even if you have to go a little heavier on a finish pass or a little lighter on a incoming pass, so we don't have to introduce a new die angle.
Well, Tom, you go out and get the customers understanding this, so I can keep selling the high-speed tapered draft machinery.
Sounds like a deal.
Worked for me.
Now let's review some key points from the video.